Hey yo, sports, how's it going? This is Gunerner Reviews. Today, we're gonna review the watch. Oh, wait. Suunto Core watch. This watch is for sports, new sports. It's for hiking. It's for everyday use. The watch. I have this watch for about 5 months. In this time period, I really wear it only for something like 2 months, because I sent the watch to the factory and the buttons broke. It went bye-bye, kaboom. So yeah, I used to wear the G-Shock for the army. It was pretty comfortable, but I wanted something more and a bit more gadgety. A bit more useless. I go 101 and pros and cons of this watch. So this is like the main menu. Just kidding, this is, you know, the first thing you see when you open the watch. Date, day 69. So we have this button. We change here, seconds, time in different area, different planet, what? It's sunset and sunrise, like I mean this hour, sunset, parce qu'on a fait un peu, star. We have timer, start here, pause here. Long press, that's about it. Another stopwatch and nothing. You can press here, boom, it's locked, can do shit. Next. So the next mode we have, as you can see here, time. What's time? Altibaro, compass, altimeter, barometer, it's the air pressure. In this watch you can see your height and the air pressure. As you can see, it's not really interesting at summer because it's consistent, but you can see here in HPA, which is, I don't really know, but it's nice when gonna be a storm, so it's the air pressure will go down and upward if the storm is over, or rain, something like that. It's on automatic profile, so when I will start rising, when I'll start walking and moving distances and heights, it will change to this 238. I can change it to here because I'm not going to open lazy. Profiles, in a depth meter, you can swim, altimeter, barometer. Move to barometer. Yep, here's the height. Okay, let me. Okay, we have here a few more options: time, meter. If you want to see how much you, I don't know, going to mountain, you can see how many meters you went. Something like that. Temperature, you know, it's not accurate when it's on your wrist, so take it off for a few minutes. Nothing. Log, you can do logs like diaries, and you can see after your trip, you know, what is your top maximum height, your minimum height, something like that. It's really nice. I don't really have logs on here because I told you I sent it to the factory, so I don't really have something to show you, sorry. And that's it. Okay. Here you have the compass, pretty straightforward. South, southeast. Southeast. Okay. Nothing. Time. Another. As you can see, you have here this little sheet. Okay, click here. Okay, now that's the point you want. You want Mashishima Zimut, okay? So you go like this in a turn right. Or, yeah, Mashishin, turn left. So it's really nice with Nifutim and shit. So that's basically it. I really wanted to show you the menu for a second. You have memory, the logs, change the time, change your location in the world, add the barometer, composite, general, you know, beats and stuff. Not really interesting. Units, miles, kilometers, meters. And yeah, so what I really love about this watch, you can see all the time what is your height and what is the temperature. So that's something I was looking for. And I don't know whether they will know as well, but this is, I don't really use. But yeah, it's pretty nice. It's the negative arm. As you can see, it's white on black, not black on white. So it's a bit hard to see sometimes, but the backlight, here's the backlight, sorry, I didn't tell you. The backlight is here. You long press here, menu. Exit. So yeah, most of the time it's locked. In winter it's really nice to see if it's going to be a rainy day or not. Today you have a smartphone and something like that, but if you don't have it and you're on a trip, this glows in the dark. But yes, folks, thank you for watching. I know it was pretty boring, but I like this watch, even though I sent it to the factory with the problem. They sent it free, only the shipping cost, unfortunately. But yes, so stay tuned, guys.